2018 Mercedes-Benz GLA250 4MATIC. Mercedes-Benz may not be known for building small, front-wheel drive-based hatchbacks, but in Europe it sells several of them. Across the pond, the luxury brand's compact range includes the A-Class hatchback, the B-Class mini MPV, available in the States as an EV, the CLA Class shooting brake wagon, and the GLA Class crossover. The four look so similar that it's hard to tell them apart. The GLA crossover we get in the US, for instance, is only 2.4 inches taller than the A-Class hatchback, and we've consistently compared it with a hotted-up hatch in look and feel since it arrived on our shores in 2014. Toughened up? Perhaps the GLA doesn't say SUV loudly enough for consumers to hear. Bucking the industry trend, the GLA crossover was outsold by its CLA sedan sibling in 2016, albeit by only a few hundred units. So it makes sense that when Mercedes updated the GLA for 2018, it put a priority on making it look more SUV rugged. Home reviews: 2018 Mercedes-Benz GLA 250 4MATIC, instrumented test. View 52 photos. Instrumented test. 2018 Mercedes-Benz GLA 250 4MATIC. The hatchback or SUV identity crisis rages on. May 2017 by Joseph Coparella. Photography by Alex Conley. Share. Tweet. Mercedes-Benz may not be known for building small, front-wheel drive-based hatchbacks, but in Europe it sells several of them. Across the pond, the luxury brand's compact range includes the A-Class hatchback, the B-Class mini MPV, available in the States as an EV, the CLA Class shooting brake wagon, and the GLA Class crossover. The four look so similar that it's hard to tell them apart. The GLA crossover we get in the US, for instance, is only 2.4 inches taller than the A-Class hatchback, and we've consistently compared it with a hotted-up hatch in look and feel since it arrived on our shores in 2014. Toughened up? Perhaps the GLA doesn't say SUV loudly enough for consumers to hear. Bucking the industry trend, the GLA crossover was outsold by its CLA sedan sibling in 2016, albeit by only a few hundred units. So it makes sense that when Mercedes updated the GLA for 2018, it put a priority on making it look more SUV rugged. View 52 photos. A new front end sports a reshaped bumper and a restyled grille that looks more like those found on Benz's larger SUVs, the GLE and the GLS. Dimpled black plastic body cladding, added along the side sills, suggests off-road ability, while the tail features a mildly reshaped bumper and restyled taillights. In our test vehicle's attractive combination of the new Canyon beige paint with 19-inch black wheels, the freshened GLA does at least have more road presence, although the jury is still out on whether it looks like a real crossover. More fun than you'd think. The GLA 250's performance, though, remains firmly in the compact hatchback camp, a good thing for drivers. Mercedes-Benz doesn't note any engine or transmission tweaks, yet this 2018 example outaccelerated its 2016 counterpart, recording a 5.8-second sprint to 60 miles per hour, versus 6.1 seconds previously. That's significantly quicker than any of its direct competitors, and hot on the heels of a Volkswagen Golf GTI with an automatic. The wild, 375-horsepower AMG GLA 45 also is available for more ardent speed freaks. The GLA 250 is not particularly sprightly in everyday driving, however, and the 7-speed dual-clutch automatic transmission is to blame. In its default comfort mode, sluggish shifts accentuate the engine's turbo lag, sport mode helps keep the 2.0-liter on boil and sharpens throttle response considerably. Firm suspension tuning and direct steering make the little Benz genuinely fun to drive, albeit at the cost of a harsh ride, and the powerful brakes stopped the GLA from 70 miles per hour in a short 160 feet, 13 feet better than the 2016 example. Questionable value. We wish Mercedes-Benz had implemented more changes to the interior, which mostly carries over save for a 1.0-inch larger infotainment screen and some additional chrome trim. It feels well-built, but the dour black plastics and overall design simply don't measure up to the standard set by Benz's superb cabins found in everything from the C-Class on up. Since the GLA's dimensions haven't changed, this refresh can't help the cramped rear seat and cargo area, which limit the practical appeal of this so-called utility vehicle. Home reviews: 2018 Mercedes-Benz GLA 250 4MATIC, instrumented test. View 52 photos. Instrumented test. 2018 Mercedes-Benz GLA 250 4MATIC. The hatchback or SUV identity crisis rages on. May 2017 by Joseph Coparella, photography by Alex Conley. Share. Tweet. Mercedes-Benz may not be known for building small, front-wheel drive-based hatchbacks, but in Europe it sells several of them. Across the pond, the luxury brand's compact range includes the A-Class hatchback, the B-Class mini MPV, available in the States as an EV, the CLA Class shooting brake wagon, and the GLA Class crossover. The four look so similar that it's hard to tell them apart. The GLA crossover we get in the US, for instance, is only 2.4 inches taller than the A-Class hatchback, and we've consistently compared it with a hotted-up hatch in look and feel since it arrived on our shores in 2014. Toughened up? Perhaps the GLA doesn't say SUV loudly enough for consumers to hear. Bucking the industry trend, the GLA crossover was outsold by its CLA sedan sibling in 2016, albeit by only a few hundred units. So it makes sense that when Mercedes updated the GLA for 2018, it put a priority on making it look more SUV rugged. View 52 photos. A new front end sports a reshaped bumper and a restyled grille that looks more like those found on Benz's larger SUVs, the GLE and the GLS. Dimpled black plastic body cladding, added along the side sills, suggests off-road ability, while the tail features a mildly reshaped bumper and restyled taillights. In our test vehicle's attractive combination of the new Canyon beige paint with 19-inch black wheels, the freshened GLA does at least have more road presence, although the jury is still out on whether it looks like a real crossover. More fun than you'd think. The GLA 250's performance, though, remains firmly in the compact hatchback camp, a good thing for drivers. Mercedes-Benz doesn't note any engine or transmission tweaks, yet this 2018 example out-accelerated its 2016 counterpart, recording a 5.8-second sprint to 60 miles per hour, versus 6.1 seconds previously. That's significantly quicker than any of its direct competitors, and hot on the heels of a Volkswagen Golf GTI with an automatic. The wild, 375-horsepower AMG GLA 45 also is available for more ardent speed freaks. View 52 photos. The GLA 250 is not particularly sprightly in everyday driving, however, and the 7-speed dual-clutch automatic transmission is to blame. In its default comfort mode, sluggish shifts accentuate the engine's turbo lag, sport mode helps keep the 2.0-liter on boil and